The blockchain as a technology, I think, is a fundamentally distributed democratic technology, which means it's meant to break down centralized forms of trust and centralized forms of power. And ultimately, I think the best use of the blockchain in the short term is going to be very simple things where you have doing things like just plain reconciliation.
Yeah.
So reconciliation sounds like a word that not many people look at, but everything that you do in life, whether it's your bank account, managing your budget, what banks do at the end of the day, what supply chain companies do at the end of the day, what pharma companies do at the end of drugs being delivered, all of that is called reconciliation. And I think that's one of the key usages of blockchain, where you allow all the parties involved in that reconciliation to all have access to exactly the same database. So for me, that's the most important one. We have a product that's currently live, and the problem with just having reconciliation is that everyone, as you talked about the parts, spare parts, is as long as you put something in the blockchain that involves human interaction, it can be a source of corruption. Yeah. So what we've been concentrating on is how do we make sure that all the information flow in the blockchain is completely automated, which means you knock out corruption, and if you knock that out, you have all the parties trusting the chain. And this requires us to then make sure that the business logic that results in the reconciliation is fully automated into the blockchain. It also means that the data that comes out of the blockchain is also fully automated, and then you can trust the artificial intelligence, whether it's machine learning, natural language processing, whatever it is. And so these three things have got to be integrated. So I think that's going to be the big things that are going to happen in the blockchain in the short term. I think the reconciliation and managing of large global contracts in things like IT managed services or any sort of managed services, I think this is already possible in certain chains. And where we see, I think all of you know Ethereum, Bitcoin, etc., these chains are incredibly primitive, because the actual amount of code that you can store in these chains are too small for, one, the size of a normal business logic integrated with the reconciliation. And I think that will need to change. That's part of the reason that we have stopped using the other chains and focused on our own chain. I think over time that will what will happen is that the contract sizes will get larger. In the future, I think that the blockchain is going to be about how we destroy oligarchic capitalism. Yeah. So when you have a big centralized hub like Google or Facebook, you're going to have the core business logic in a platform, and you're going to have multiple small players able to use that platform in the future. And I think at least that's what our hope is, and that then just all of that profit that's currently centralized with BASF, with Google, with Citibank, etc., all of that profit then gets distributed amongst a number of small players. That's going to be good for capitalism and good for society.
And that comes on to the point of what is blockchain law.